Hello students, I hope you all are doing well. Now, today in Civics, we'll start up with a new lesson, Urban Local Self-Government. So let's begin. We all know that cities are densely populated and spread over a bigger area. The problems faced by the urban people are more complex. They need good transport, drinking water, electricity, schools, hospitals, etc. Therefore, urban local bodies are constituted differently. The type of an urban local body depends upon the size of the city population. Next, we'll study what does a metropolitan area means. Now, according to the Constitution, 74th Amendment Act, 1992, which defines a metropolitan area in India as an area having a population of 10 lakhs or more, comprising one or more districts and consisting of two or more municipalities. And here you can see the pictures of some metropolitan cities. Metropolitan city in India is a city with a population of more than 10 lakh. They are huge cities with a large population and industries. Job opportunities and industries are the major reasons to attract people to a particular city and make it a metropolitan city. Then these cities have better infrastructure, health facilities, connectivity, and growth opportunities. Then at present, India has more than 45 metropolitan cities which have a population of more than 10 lakhs. Apart from being highly populated, metropolitan cities play a key role in the development of the country. And due to the presence of numerous industries, the contribution of metropolitan cities in country's GDP is more than other cities in India. Among all metropolitan cities in India, Delhi is on the first position in terms of population. Now, the top 10 metropolitan cities in India are Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai, Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Ahmedabad, Pune, Surat, and Jaipur. Now, the local bodies of small cities are called municipalities or municipal committees. And the local body of bigger cities such as Delhi, Chennai, Mumbai, and Kolkata are called Nagar Nigam or Municipal Corporation. There are more than 50 municipal corporations in our country. Now we'll study about municipalities and municipal corporation one by one. So we'll start up with municipalities. Now the cities with a population of up to 3 lakhs are managed by municipalities, also known as municipal committees. Now here the people of the city elect the members of a municipality. The number of members depend upon the size of the city. The city is divided into a number of wards. Seats are reserved for scheduled castes and scheduled tribes and other backward classes and women. Some other experienced members in the field of science, art, education and medicine are nominated by elected representatives. They are known as aldermen. The members, also known as councillors, elect a chairperson and vice chairperson. The chairperson presides over the meetings that are held at regular intervals. In his absence, the vice chairperson performs the functions of the chairperson. There are some permanent officials like the executive officer, education officer, secretary, health officer, sanitary inspector, municipal engineer, junior engineers, etc. Next, we'll study some of the qualifications of a voter. Now, the first point is the voter should be having a minimum age of 18 years. Then he should be having an Indian citizenship, should be a resident of the city, and he should have an enrollment in the voters list. Next, we'll study about the qualifications of a contestant. Now, the contestant should have a minimum age of 25 years, should be an Indian citizen, and should be the resident of the city. Next, we'll study about municipal corporation, also known as Nagar Nigam. Now, these are the local bodies of bigger cities. Now, here the members of a municipal corporation are elected in the same manner as the members of the municipality. Now, these members are called councillors. These councillors elect some other members, the aldermen, who are respected citizens and are known for their experience. The members elect a mayor and a deputy mayor. The mayor presides over the meetings and looks after the work of the corporation. The mayor and the deputy mayor are elected for a term that varies between 1 and 5 years. Next, we'll start up with the functions of the local bodies. The local problems of a town or a city are tackled by the local government bodies. There are some compulsory functions which the local bodies has to perform, and there are some optional functions which may be performed by the local body only if it has ample finances. So we'll start up with the compulsory functions. Now, compulsory functions under public health and other conveniences. Now, the first point is keeping the city clean is the primary duty of the municipality. The municipality has to make arrangements for the removal of the garbage and waste. Drains are needed to flush out dirty water from the cities and towns. The municipalities not only keep the cities clean, but they also manage or make arrangements for vaccination against smallpox and inoculation against diseases like cholera, plague, and tuberculosis. The municipalities also make arrangements for checking food adulteration. A municipality open hospitals, dispensaries and other medical centers in different localities where qualified doctors are employed. One of the important functions of a municipality is to keep a record of all the births and deaths in the city. It helps in planning of welfare services for the people. Now, some other measures which are undertaken by the local bodies in the urban areas for the convenience of the public are construction and maintenance of good and wide roads and streets, planting of trees along the roadside, supply of electricity to houses and factories, construction of public conveniences at busy centers. Next, we'll study about some more compulsory functions under public education. Now, education prepares responsible citizens. It helps in the welfare and progress of an individual as well as the society. For this purpose, the local bodies open primary schools for children. The local bodies also set up reading rooms, public libraries and museums, etc. Next, we'll study the compulsory functions under public security. Now, every municipality or a corporation maintains fire brigades for saving the life of people and their property in case of an outbreak of fire. It can also pull down old, dangerous and illegal houses which may cause mishappenings. Next, we'll study about some of the optional functions. A municipality or a corporation may develop parks and gardens. It may develop a zoo, a museum and some picnic spots as well. They can even construct children's homes, orphanages, rest houses, etc. Local bodies in bigger cities also provide their own transport facility that are cheap and efficient. Next, we'll study about some of the sources of income of these local bodies. The first one is octroi duty. Now, the tax on goods brought into or taken out of the town come under octroi duty. Then income from municipal property. Now, tax paid is rent by shopkeepers and traders selling goods in the markets. Then the next one is the entertainment tax. Now, tax collected from those who provide different kinds of entertainment. For example, the cinema halls come under entertainment tax. Then comes the government grants. The municipalities also receive annual financial grant from the state government. Next is the house tax. Now, tax on houses in the town. The tax is fixed by the municipality according to the annual rental value of the houses. Next comes the water tax. Now, tax is charges for providing clean water for drinking. People who have municipality taps in their houses have to pay it. And the last one is the profession tax. Lawyers, doctors and other professionals may have to pay profession tax on their annual income. With this, we come to an end of our lesson. I hope you all have understood it well. And kindly refer to the video again for a better understanding. I'll be sending you the question answers and exercises. Question answers to be done in the notebook and exercises to be done in the textbook. So kindly complete your work and do take care of yourselves and have a nice day. Thank you.